Hello, from a very puffy face to me. I'm trying to really. I put on extra makeup today to really try and de-tired my face. I got back from New York at 1:30 this morning. It's now 11:30, so it's been quite a slow start to the day. I'm only just now getting ready. I had about 5 hours sleep in the past 30 hours. Couldn't sleep on the flight at all. Just wasn't tired, and then wasn't particularly tired when I got home either. Yeah, I'm now getting ready. I'm gonna go into work, catch up with everyone, and just make a plan for the week, because we've got a lot going on this week. The gallery has its last opening of the year. We have our Christmas party, which I can't wait for. It's like the first time in a long time that I've had a staff Christmas party to go to. That's something I've missed quite a lot, being self-employed. You don't have that sort of like end of year hurrah with all of your workmates. So I'm really looking forward to that. I'd say this week is my busiest week of this month work-wise, both gallery and content creation. And then after that, it's going to slow down a bit, which I'm really looking forward to because I kind of nest a bit, get things looking a bit Christmassy, and get the Christmas tree, tidy up the house, get the Christmas candles out, do all those nice little rituals that start making the house feel a lot cozier. Because although, like when I was in New York, I felt really festive. Got really excited about coming home, and then when I came home, realized I had such a big to-do list of things that just need to get done this week. So I just thought, right, if I just crack through my to-do list over the next few days, then over the weekend we can get the tree, just do all those nice things that will start to make it feel like Christmas. Dean did buy a tub of roses, which always signals the start of Christmas, doesn't it? It is cold today, but it's raining. I was kind of hoping this rain would be snow, but the reality is when it's forecast to snow, it never really does properly snow. It's just a sort of slush. Although the clouds do look kind of snowy. I guess if it drops a little bit more in temperature, we might get some snow. My shoelace is undone as well. What's worse than having your socks slip down into your shoe is your shoelace undone when you've got bags and umbrella and can't actually bend down to do it up. I'm almost at work though, so it's fine. Yeah, it's cold, sheepskin weather kind of cold, which is nice. Also, this silk scarf that I'm wearing is really pulling in a good shift. I don't know where I was before I had a silk scarf. They're so much easier to wear than big, bulky wool scarves. Right, I can finally put my stuff down now.
Deep. So I logged in, I was like, right, I'll print this and then I'll put the collection, and I just realised that, which is fine, because I think you would have already been in.
Okay, not exactly the thickest covering of snow this morning, but there's definitely a little bit there. Oh, doesn't the sky look nice this morning? Yeah, there's definitely some on the floor, but nothing to get overly excited about. I just recorded this whole segment. Well, thought I recorded it and realised I hadn't actually pressed record. So take two. This is my attempt to be chic yet practical on this icy day. Got this beanie in New York. I was thinking about doing a bit of a New York haul and then realised most of the things I bought were souvenirs and food. I bought this hat and a t-shirt. They're the only sort of like clothing things I got. I found this in Assembly. I had heard of Assembly before, but didn't realize I had a physical store. It's a really cool store with a really nice mix of brands. Some I'd heard of, some I hadn't. This brand, Kabelima, I think it's pronounced, is a Japanese brand that I've not heard of before. This beanie is 100% cashmere and it's super soft and cozy. I got that Coswam. It's too small for my head. I wore it for a day and it was extremely irritating. It just, yeah, it's too tight for me and it was really irritating my forehead. And I realised that a beanie with a little bit more chunk to it is more flattering for my face shape. Those sort of thinner, skinnier beanies just don't look right on me proportionally. But I tried it. The scarf, however, is beautiful, really nice. Just a plain black turtleneck underneath from Uniqlo, one of their merino wool ones. House of Dagmar Valentina trousers, 3 years on, and they're still the best black tailored trousers. And then, do you remember I was saying how I wanted a heavier version of that House of Dagmar coat? Well, I pretty much found it like a week later, an almost identical version. This is from Turn Studios. Sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong. Beautiful, beautiful brand. Yeah, it's exactly what I was looking for. Just a plain black coat that's nice and heavy, but with a little bit of cinch at the waist. Perfecto. And then Salomon XT4s in a new blue colourway that they released a couple of months ago. I found these via Hipstore. If you struggle as a woman to find trainers, check out Hipstore, as in like sort of Salomon's, New Balance, those kinds of trainers. Because men obviously always have great accessibility when it comes to trainers, but I often find it's difficult to find them in women's sizes, and Hipstore are quite good at getting the, you know, the new cool trainers in women's sizes. So do check them out. I got the white version back in the summer and took them to Wales to go walking in. They're absolutely filthy now, obviously, the white. I need to clean them. But they were so comfortable. So I figured these would be quite a good addition. They've got some hella grip on the bottom as well, so I think they'll be great for today because it's really icy out there. And then just the Roe Bindle, I reckon. Sorry, me again. I was just picking out gloves. And how nice is this little colour combo of like camel and blue? Very nice. These are from, I reckon these are the Uniqlo cashmere ones, you know. Yes. Good old Uniqlo. Ooh, it's bright today. This is up there as one of my top weather types, though. You know, crisp, cold, but not cloud in the sky. So it's nice and bright. I'm on my way to work. We have our last opening of the year today. It's a group show in the Irish Gallery. It's going to be great. So I'm on my way there to photograph it all because everything's been hung. And the gallery is all clear, so I'm going to photograph everything. And yeah, that's my main job for today. I'm actually kind of hot, which is mad because the weather forecast says it's -1. Either this coat and hat are doing a great job, or the weather forecast is lying. Right, I'm off to work. Very much the pattern of this week's vlog, just me saying, right, I'm off to work. But it's been a very work heavy week this week, and today is no exception. I'm going to be sat at my computer editing photos and videos all day. So yeah, it's just a day sat in the office. Last night was really good. I don't think I captured much footage just because I was kind of on photo duty and like other content duties. So I was kind of here, there and everywhere, but it was a really good evening. Such a good turnout. Felt like a lovely way to toast the final show of the year, kind of like celebrating a year of Moosey and just catching up with everyone. And yeah, it was just a really good evening. Lots of mulled wine, Bailey's mince pies, felt very festive. Tonight is the big one though. Tonight is the Christmas party. I know I've mentioned this several times already, but I'm so excited to have this kind of thing back again. You don't really have it as a self-employed person, unless you kind of properly like organise that kind of thing with, like, I guess people you've worked with or whatever. But yeah, it's not something I've had for a very long time. I cannot wait. Today's outfit, I'm going to brave it in a skirt. I have got tights on though, and socks. They are thermal tights also. Old season MHL vest, but obviously sweater vests are having a moment, so it's pretty easy to find like a black V-neck sweater vest around at the moment. Cos belt, 12 story skirt that came back from the tailor last week. Much better on the back here. I have left a bit of a gap so that I can still tuck knitwear in. I think I've got that a bit too high. Is that? No, that's good. And then the Roe garden boots, and I'm going to put on my Corley Studio sheepskin coat. Proportionally, I'm not 100% sure about this, but this coat is so warm, and that's kind of all I really care about right now. So I'm going to go with the Corley Studio sheepskin. It doesn't look too bad. I think just because, you know what I'm like, I'm so used to just wearing massive long coats. As soon as I put on something cropped, I'm like, oh, this is weird. But I'll get used to it, I guess. It's just so toasty, and I don't have to worry about like overly layering in this coat because it does, it's fine. Like all I've got on underneath is the sweater vest and the t-shirt. Right, I'm going. Goodbye. Thought I'd come nosy at what you guys have been up to.
Alright, look, I'm gonna try and find it behind my back, around here. Yeah, six of it. There it is. That wasn't it, was it? Okay. Six.
Thank
you. Right, six. You know what, actually? I haven't done this one before.
No! Barely any footage of last night because just that's the way my vlogging goes, but it was fun, wasn't it?
It was.
I'm gonna try to put my seatbelt on one-handed.
Okay.
We're now off to go get our Christmas tree because it's the 10th of December and we still don't have a single Christmas decoration up. So we're just gonna Christmasify the house today and just try and nurse this hangover with a garden centre lunch. I just want something with like gravy, stuffing maybe, sausage. I don't know, I just want something warm.
The Christmas sandwich last year was the best sandwich.
Yeah, it was one of the best Christmas sandwiches I've ever had. I just want something warm that's just going to make me feel good again. Yeah, do we want fluffy and green? Fluffy and blue, or like spindly in green.
It's quite nice.
I don't. It's not. Its
you
shape
want it
isn't
to be
great.
More,
this one's quite good here.
I want it to be more like that.
Yeah, rather than standing
so like that one.
Up. Yeah, that one's quite nice. Right, I think we found a winner. Not too tall, not too wide. Nice shape. Yeah, I think this is a good one. Nice colour as well.
Thank you.
by standing in my kitchen and filming this outfit, I'm doing these clothes a bit of disservice, but this is literally the only spot in the house that gets like an ounce of sunlight at the moment. Anyway, this might be a bit of an over-exaggeration, but I don't think I've ever had such a beautiful ready-to-wear brand sponsor a video than the brand that is sponsoring this week's video. So I'm working with a brand called Alice Collective. If you follow me over on Instagram and you're quite engaged with the brands I tag and stuff, then you might recognise Alice Collective. I worked with them on this imagery in the summer, and I'm working with them again to create some more imagery for their autumn winter collection, but also going to feature some of the pieces in a YouTube video. I would describe Anna's Collective as like a quiet luxury brand. They're very much like craftsmanship and materials first, and that can be quite difficult to convey through photos. Don't get me wrong, the clothes photograph beautifully, they do all the hard work for me, it's so easy to photograph the pieces. But it's sometimes quite hard to get across just how incredible the fabrics and the cuts really are and the craftsmanship. So thought it would be a good opportunity to just feature a few pieces in this week's YouTube video. So Anna's Collective are, like I said, they're a quiet luxury brand, so they really align with a lot of the other brands I shop and buy from. And it's very much about a brand that really explores kind of like almost like architecture within fashion. So there's lots of really interesting shapes and cuts combined with some incredible, beautiful materials. And they actually have a boutique in Shanghai, which looks, I only just found this out a couple of days ago, which looks so nice. If I ever find myself in Shanghai, I would love to go. If you find yourself in Shanghai, then I highly recommend a visit. It looks beautiful. And you can actually see some of the pieces up close. Anyway, I picked out a couple of pieces from their autumn winter collection just to borrow for this video. Unfortunately, I'm not keeping the pieces. I would love to keep them. So this outfit, as much as I would love to wear it out, I'm not actually going to wear it out because I'm terrified that I might do something to the pieces. Knowing my luck, the one outfit that has to be sent back, I'd probably end up spilling something on it or I'd fall over. Anyway, this outfit in particular feels very me, very, very me. Firstly, because it's head to toe navy. And those of you that watch regularly and actually listen to these wafflings that I do will know that navy's like pretty much my favourite colour, and it's a colour that I always wear, like fall back on when I want to feel like myself. So in this instance, I feel very me. And also I feel like this outfit's a really nice combination of those sculptural shapes and interesting textures, which is two elements of my style that I feel like are quite constant that I always try and like play around with. So starting from the top, this navy turtleneck, which from the distance that you are, probably actually looks like a regular navy turtleneck. However, it's crafted from a blend of cashmere, wool and silk. So if only someone had invented the ability for you to actually touch this and actually feel the textures through the screen, because honestly, this is like the softest material I've ever felt in like a turtleneck form. Honestly, it's incredible. But as you get up close, you might be able to spot that there's actually some really fine details that you don't see on first glance, which I think is a lot of what I like to kind of have within my wardrobe. Like, I like clothes with like interesting small details that you don't necessarily notice on first glance. So if you see up close, you've got all the kind of like the regular weave stitch or whatever, and then there's a very subtle kind of like dense ribbed detail that goes all the way along here and kind of like wraps round and goes down and also kind of wraps round the arm. I'm really not going to be able to do it justice on camera, I don't think. It's so incredibly done. I'm like staring at it like, how is this done? It's like the most, such a dense ribbed detail. It's really, it's so delicate, but so beautiful. And I'm kind of wondering whether this detail here almost creates like, I put the turtleneck on and I was like, oh, it's quite flattering. It almost has like a nice sort of shape to it. And I think it might be the illusion of this detail that's kind of making that. And also with the arm, it just kind of, it gives it a bit of something. And I'm not sure what the something is, but it's definitely doing something, isn't it? Anyway, the skirt. Okay, I've lowered the tripod and hopefully you'll be able to see better view of the skirt now. I'm speechless, honestly. This skirt is so beautiful It's just, so it's a wool silk blend, and I think the blend of those two fabrics is what's giving it this really nice structure. It almost feels a little bit like, I'm trying to think how I can describe how this feels. It's smooth and it's soft, but it's also quite kind of crunchy. Wow. Imagine like a scuba material, but a little bit more delicate, like a little bit finer. It's kind of like that. It's absolutely stunning. It has pockets, really beautiful, kind of like big high-waisted band next to this kind of like voluminous shape. It creates such a nice shape. I've paired it with just some loafers. I think this would be such a nice kind of like, if you're, I mean, I would wear this to work if I'm honest, but I'm trying to think of another context I could wear this in. Like if you're going out for a meeting, maybe, I don't know. I would actually probably wear this as an evening look as well, even with the loafer, but I would maybe swap the loafer out for something a little bit more, maybe like a pointed mule. That could be quite nice, like a something sparkly. I cannot send this back, Alice. I'm sorry, it's absolutely stunning. So I'm going to spend the next hour or so around the house trying to put off having to take this off and put my normal clothes back on to go out. I'm just going to spend the next hour around the house just feeling, oh, I love it. Ah! Although I don't have to send this back until after Christmas, so I could potentially, if anyone's having like a nice little dinner and drinks around their house in the next week or so, I could wear it. I could wear it. I feel incredibly smart today. I'm heading to London in a moment, and I'm staying the night because I've got a very early pickup time tomorrow morning, 6:30 a.m. to take me to the Eurostar because I'm going to Paris with Chanel. So I feel like this smart dressing is quite warranted for a trip with Chanel. Just to break down the outfit, this kind of snood thing is from Totem. This is really good for when I'm wearing a coat that can't fit many layers underneath. So I layer this over the top. This coat is quite heavy and it is thick, but it's quite slim fitting, so I can't fit loads of layers underneath. So underneath I've put a cashmere jumper on, then I've got a Heat Tech cami underneath that, and then this acts as a really nice windbreaker. It kind of just stops any breeze or chill kind of getting into my coat. When I first got it, I was a bit like, is this gonna serve a purpose? And actually it's really cozy, kind of just keeps the upper body really warm. Then I've got weekday rail jeans on, the churn coat again, GH Bass loafers, and then my Celine clasp handbag. While I'm in London this evening, I thought I would catch up with some friends and go out for a nice dinner. This shirt does not look as nice as it does in real life on camera. It sort of has a bit of a sheen. It's almost like a sort of browny, coppery colour, not quite gold. Is that going to show up? Yeah, that shows it a bit better. It looks a little bit sort of like silk organza. It's not, it's tencel, but it has that sort of like organza look to it, and it's got really nice sleeve detail and slightly elongated collar. I've been contemplating whether to switch to a nude bra or keep with the black. When I put the nude on, it looks a bit strange because you can kind of just about see it, whereas the black, I feel like it looks more intentional, and it's like, okay, fine, that's the statement, but I'm not 100% sure. Cos belt and then long black skirt. Maybe if I come over here, there you go, you can see that a bit better, and tabby boots. I haven't worn these in so long, so I'm very excited to get these back out, and then I'll wear a black coat with that Totem snood shawl thing again.
Yeah.
always try to balance the camera on precarious places. You are balanced on the door handle that leads to the balcony. Those lights, this camera doesn't like those lights and they're flickering, but not actually flickering in real life. Anyway, hello from Paris. I'm not feeling too sharp right now. I'm very happy to be here, but since I last spoke to you, some sort of like sinus infection or maybe like a cold has started to develop and I'm not feeling too sharp. And I don't think the early start this morning of 5:30 has helped, but we got here about 2 hours, maybe 3 hours ago, went for some lunch and just had like loads of veg, a green juice, some like a vegetable soup. So I'm hoping that will just make me feel a little bit more human again, because I was struggling on the Eurostar. I tried to sleep as much as I could. So I've got about 45 minutes now free just to kind of do what I want. So I'm actually just going to do some work. I've got some gallery bits that I need to do. And then we are going on a walking tour, which I will vlog bits of. I haven't been to Paris that much. I think I've maybe been here three or four times. And it's always been work related. I don't think I've ever been here just as like a kind of like leisurely trip. So I never really get my bearings when I'm in Paris. I don't know where anything is. I couldn't pinpoint anything on a map at all if you asked me to. So I'm actually quite excited to go for just a walk around. It is, however, extremely cold. It's forecast to snow tomorrow. So I need to layer up a bit more and yeah, just prepare myself for the cold, especially as the sun goes down. I don't know why I'm going to try and film this, because you probably won't be able to see any of it, but I'm also wearing exactly the same thing I wore last night, but I've swapped out the shirt for a turtleneck. I just had a bath and feel so much better for it. We had an hour free after our walk before we head out to dinner, and I just thought, right, I'm sitting in the bath for half an hour, and I did exactly that, sat and ate Pringles and watched YouTube videos, and I feel like I've really, because I started to get the shakes, you know, when you get those sort of like cold shakes, and my whole body was aching. So sitting in the bath really helped. Now it just feels like it's all in my throat, which I can totally handle. Glad that my body isn't aching anymore. So yeah, tonight's look for dinner is exactly the same as last night, but I've put on a turtleneck this time because I just want to feel a little bit cozy and a little bit more comfortable. That shirt is lovely, but I feel a bit exposed in it because it's kind of see-through and it is quite tight on the arms. So this way, I just feel like I feel a bit more comfortable. I'm not in the mood for anything too tight-fitting. We are going for dinner at a place called Gigi, and I think I'm running a little bit late, so I'm going to go and meet everyone in the lobby. Guys, I've gone against everything I ever said about coffee. I am now quite a regular coffee drinker. I'm sure I'll go back to non-coffee at some point, but I am deep in a coffee kind of era at the moment. I realise that the Paris footage abruptly stopped, and here I am now back home.
That is because I deteriorated quite quickly on the trip and did not feel good. But I just want to say that the exhibition that's just opened, which is why I was there to preview the fragrance exhibition that they've just opened, is very cool. It's this kind of immersive, very interactive exhibition that celebrates the five sort of fragrance groups that Chanel have. So there's a room dedicated to each group, and inside there's lots of things you can kind of interact with. There's games you can play and stuff. It's very cool. If you're into fragrance, or just like Chanel in general, or just a fun exhibition, and you find yourself in Paris in the next couple of weeks, I think it's on until the 8th of January, but don't quote me on that. I know it's not on for long. Then do check it out. So yeah, I'm home. Poor Dean, bless him, he's been so ill while I've been away. He's had it much worse than me. He's had a fever. He's been on the sofa for like 3 days. One of the days he was being sick. So it's been a rough week for the two of us. However, sorry, it's so icy, like it snowed last night and then froze over. Oh no, I need to go this way. So now it's like an ice rink absolutely everywhere. However, there is light at the end of the tunnel, or at the end of this week, should I say, for both of us. Yesterday we received an email from our solicitor letting us know that today we are finally exchanging on our new house. It's been 8 months, almost 8 months exactly to the date actually that we put an offer in on this house. 8 months of emotional labour, and then we've been told we will be completing tomorrow. So hopefully, if everything all goes right, by the end of day tomorrow, we will have keys to our new house, and I can't quite believe I'm saying it. There's been so many highs and lows during this process. We really thought at many points it wasn't going to happen. I've gone the wrong way. God, I can't believe I've done this. We didn't think this was going to happen. I didn't want to say it out loud because I didn't want to jinx it, and because there were so many points where I just thought it wasn't going to happen for us. But it's finally happening. We've bought a new house. I can't wait to show you it. I can't wait to get stuck in with everything we have planned for it. We've tried our best not to get too invested in it. Like, you try so hard not to kind of picture yourself in the house and all the things you're going to do to it until you've kind of know definitely for sure you're getting it. But we have done a lot of planning, a lot of discussing, a lot of Pinterest browsing and all that. So we do have grand plans for it, and I can't wait to document the process. But yeah, when we get the keys tomorrow, I imagine we will go to the house just to kind of reacquaint ourselves with it. It's been so long since we saw it. I kind of like forgotten some parts of the house. So I'll show you that when we get there tomorrow. We don't plan on moving in this year. We've got a lot of things we need to do to it before we can move into it. So it's going to be some great vlog content, isn't it? So yeah, just really feeling like it's such a nice way to end the year. We've been so lucky. We literally got this over the line at the very last minute, because I think solicitors and estate agents shut like on Tuesday or Wednesday. So another reason why we didn't think this was going to happen this side of Christmas, but feels like we can go into the new year now knowing that we've got this amazing project to start once we get back from Australia. But there's lots of things that we will have done to the house while we were away in Australia. Like, we need the whole house rewiring, several other bits like that are just good to get done while we're not around. Anyway, more of that can be discussed tomorrow. I'm trying my best not to fall over right now. I guess I will check back in tomorrow when a set of keys is firmly in my hand. Guys, I jinxed it. It's Friday. It's just gone 4 p.m. and we don't have keys for our house. I knew I shouldn't have said anything out loud before actually being in the position of opening the front door of the new house. We've been told that it's not going to happen today. It needed to have happened by 4:15. It's now like 4:10. It's frustrating because we were also told that everything was in place and that we were good to go, ready to complete on the house today. It hasn't happened. There has been a delay. And we've also been told that completion can't happen over a weekend. It has to happen on a weekday. So now we wait until Monday. We haven't actually been given the kind of like definite, you know, like it's definitely going to happen Monday, but we've been told it will likely happen Monday. So I'm being quite pessimistic and thinking, might not happen Monday, but we shall see.
It's Tuesday, it is almost midday, and we still do not have a house. I am trying my best to hold it together right now. Today will be the third time we have been told that everything is good to go ahead and that we're ready to exchange and complete on the house. I'm hoping third time's lucky, but the way Friday went and the way yesterday went, I'm feeling a bit pessimistic. It's nothing to do with what's happening on our side, it's something to do with the seller side that's holding it up, but it's just very frustrating to have been told twice now that we're ready to go ahead, it's going to happen, and then it doesn't happen. So today we have until 4:15 to complete. If we don't exchange and complete by 4:15, it rolls on to the next day. Obviously I'm very annoyed at the situation, because Friday was the date that was set. I'm annoyed that it's not happening, but I'm also frustrated because I wanted this vlog to have been up by now. The plan was to, get the house Friday and then end the vlog, and then on Sunday it would go live and it'd be like, hey guys, we bought a house. But I really don't want to end the vlog on a cliffhanger, because once this vlog is done and uploaded, there won't be another vlog until the new year. So if this ends without us having got the house, then it's just going to be this cliffhanger. And I want to get this vlog up for Christmas, and it's Tuesday, and I want to get this up by Friday at the latest. So, I mean, we have to exchange and complete this week. Like, we have to, because the office is then shut for like 2 weeks, so it has to happen this week. But it's just whether it will happen at the beginning of, like, earlier in the week, or if it's going to be like a Friday miracle, and then you'll get a vlog. You'll probably end up getting a vlog on Christmas Eve, you know? Apologies, my camera just abruptly died on me then while I was about to show you my outfit. So I decided to sit and do some work whilst waiting for the camera to charge. In that small space of time, I received the heartbreaking phone call to let us know it is unlikely that we will exchange and complete on our house today. Third time not so lucky, I guess. I wonder if is fourth time luckier saying? I'm trying my best not to be overly pessimistic, but we've got 3 days left, so we shall see. In the meantime, I'll show you my outfit, shall I? My outfit of the day. It's an all black outfit, but I feel like it's made up of some nice textures and some of my favourite pieces, actually. So Shayna Moat knit this kind of like cocoon oversized jumper. I really like the cocoon shape because it kind of stops, it makes it look quite intentionally oversized. Kind of cocoon sleeve, cocoon body, and then a high neck, but like a sort of wide high neck that sits upright. Homme plissé pleated trousers. I'm still feeling a little bit so when I'm getting dressed I just kind of want to be a bit cozy and all like just feel safe and secure, but I'm kind of getting to the point now where I'm like I want to feel nice as well. I want to feel nice again, and sometimes clothes can kind of trick you into feeling a bit better than you actually feel. So these trousers are a good combination because they're elasticated on the waist, they're so comfortable, but because they're complice, they feel a little bit, a little bit fancy. And then I'm wearing my tabby boots. I've not worn these in ages, actually. I just feel so nice when I put them on. I think the heel height is great because you can, like, I personally find them really easy to walk around in for the entire day. Sorry, my voice went a bit weird there. So they're the all black elements. And then my coat is from Peter Petrov. I actually found this in like a clearance section on their website recently. Having seen it on the triplets when I was in Paris, I was like, okay, that coat is gorgeous. Saw that it was like 2 years old, then discovered this little clearance section on their website and they had one left in my size. It's very cool in that the belt doesn't go around the back, it kind of feeds into the coat, if you know what I mean. So the belt is on the inside, if that makes sense, and it comes out of this little cutout and you can fasten it up and then just tie it around the front like so, or the belt can also be fed back through this little opening and you can kind of then button it up and just tie it like here, so you just see the like the knot hanging out. Just for a bit of ease, I've kind of just been tying it up around the front. But I really like the look of it when it's fully tied. Sorry, this is like, I just like that hangs, but then this is all sort of like tied and secure in. I then can't figure out whether I want to wear my just my regular black Arquette beanie that I always wear the grey version of this. It is a very good beanie, sorry. Or a hood thing. This is more like a bonnet. I've tried the sort of full hood thing, but I find them, I just can't find the right hood for me. And often when I'm wearing like a turtleneck or something with a high neck, I find there's a bit too much fabric. And I think a bonnet is where I'm gonna succeed in this whole hood thing, because it just sits like a strap underneath my chin. There's no worry of like excess material around the neck. So yeah, I might wear that, you know, I'm not sure. And then bag. I'm in two minds as to whether to wear this out. So this is from Anest Collective, and it's so, so beautiful. But I just don't want to damage it, obviously. But I did a test run, and I can fit so much in it. I can literally fit tons of stuff in this bag, and it can be worn crossbody, which would be great today because I've got a lot to carry around with me, and I would just like to be able to have it hanging on my body rather than having to like carry a big tote bag or something. I need to adjust the strap a little, but it's just, I think the little touch of gold looks really nice with the colour of this coat. Especially because I've not got much jewellery on, but I've got gold jewellery on, and it's just a nice little, like, little touch of gold. It's such a beautiful bag, though. Really, really beautiful. There's also a compartment in the back. There's just, like, never-ending compartments in this bag. One, two, three, four compartments in the front, one in the back. It's very good, very good. Right, I've got a whole list of things I need to do, and I should get doing them now. This is our new house. Like 5 minutes ago, we were like, let's go straight to the house. That's where we just came in. So then if I turn around, this is the front entrance. We've got a really nice staircase leading upstairs. Bathroom, really big bathroom on the right-hand side here. Then as you go through, a front room with huge, huge windows. And then into this dining space, which then leads out into the garden, which is, it's so big. I can't get over how big this garden is. I'll go out there in just a moment. And then this door here leads into the kitchen. And then I'll go upstairs. Dean trying to get in. And then upstairs, which I've completely forgotten what upstairs looks like actually. A window in the hallway, which is great, letting loads of light. Up the stairs, there are four doors. This one here is the bathroom. Sorry, this can't actually get out wide enough to sort of show you the rooms properly. And then here we have bedroom one. We think this will probably be our bedroom because it faces the back rather than the front. Again, huge, huge windows. And then bedroom two, which is actually pretty much the same size as bedroom one, but we would prefer to just be looking out into the garden, I think. And then bedroom number three, nice square-shaped room that we'll probably use as an office space. Oh, I've just noticed a very nice curved detail on the ceiling there. And then that's the view back down. So this is it. What are you, Dean's already trying to check what's under the carpet. Oh, what's that? Oh, there are floorboards. We really like the wooden floor. And we're kind of hoping that the wooden floor just continues throughout most of the house. It looks like it does.
Yeah.
Because it's wooden in this room. So it's just going to be a case of ripping up all of the carpets and kind of sanding back the floor and getting it back to nice condition. It's just started raining, so I'm going to try and show you the garden from the doors here. It's a huge garden space at the back here. Then we have a garage just there, and then the garden. Do you know what? Actually, I'll just go outside. The garden continues round the side of the house here. But our plan is to, because this bit on the corner here is just where the kitchen is, our plan is to extend completely out to the side where that extension is now, and make the kitchen a lot bigger. So we'll still have a bit of a side garden here, but all of this will be kitchen space. That's our only really solid plan at the moment. That's the back entrance of the garage. This is the rest of the garden. Hello. This seems like a good time to finally sign off a vlog. This is the point that I wanted to sign it off on the high note. I've probably said this already, but I can't quite believe we've got it.
It's been 8 months.
8 months, over 8 months, technically 8 months and like a week of emotional labour, but we finally have it. So between now and going to Australia, we'll just be doing stuff like getting rid of the carpet, get rid of the wallpaper, do you think?
Yes.
Get an architect in and start drawing up a plan, really, because it'd be great to get a plan in to submit to planning permission ASAP. And then once we get back to Australia, we've got a real project to kind of get stuck into. So it's going to be... it's going to be... 2023 is going to be a good and exciting year for house stuff. So I'm going to leave it there. That's it. This is the vlog done. This is like my Christmas and New Year sign off, I guess, because I won't have another vlog up now until in the New Year. So I hope you all have a lovely Christmas and a great New Year, whatever your plans are. And I shall see you all in 2023.
Have fun.
Bye, have fun.